Okay, so during the session, I would like to first talk about what just happened, and then the second half of the session, so for the last like 5 to 7.5 minutes, I'd like to talk about your sort of affect around what happened, so I can gain an understanding of what you saw and perceived, and then also kind of what your feelings are surrounding it. So tell me a little bit about what happened for you.
Well, we went out to the car to bring him to the airport, and then it didn't start, and it was kind of like, this could have happened at any other time, it would have been fine.
Mm-hmm.
But the whole point of us getting a car was so we could bring people back and forth to the airport.
Yes.
So that's what happened. Oh, and then it didn't start, so we called Mike, and he's like, well, it's gotta be this. So, and I tried it, and like really, like I tried hard.
Yeah.
And it still didn't work, and then do you want to get into how I feel?
Well, it's up to you, really. We can, let's talk about first not feelings, and then we'll talk about feelings in a bit.
So essentially that's what happened. The car didn't work, and we had to call Mike. Mike's working, so he called Josh, who's not working, to come see if he could try it. But in all this time, paying us to go to the airport, and like, one of the things you don't want to mess around with is missing a plane.
Yeah.
So it didn't work.
Okay. And what do you think other people were thinking during the situation?
It's hard to say. Like, I mean, I think I got the most frustrated. Not like frustrated, but I feel like I'm the one responsible.
Right.
Not necessarily that I caused it to break, but that, you know, we're here. We have guests. And then our connection to the car is through my relationship with Mike.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I feel responsible, because somehow, so I don't think Pam, I don't know exactly how her brain works, mm-hmm. but she probably, if I were in her situation, there'd be a line where like, it's okay because we can still get a cab, but then once that line is crossed, it's like, I need to get the airport now.
Mm-hmm.
It was a plane.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think she was like that, and maybe that's just how she is too. She wouldn't even care if she missed it.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know. He doesn't really have anything invested in here, so
mm-hmm.
I mean, he is probably frustrated, or not frustrated, but like, can understand why it's this kind of a problem. So
right.
He helps out, and that's nice. And you're in the middle, kind of, because you're like me, we're responsible for it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're also Pam's friend, so you understand how Pam works a little more.
Mm-hmm.
So you're probably a little more sensitive. It's hard to say, like, who's more sensitive to that, like, whether I'm sensitive more, because I don't know how she's feeling, so I might derive all sorts of conclusions,
mm-hmm.
or if you are, because you know who she is.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Different levels of frustration.
Right. Okay. So you have ideas about the way that everybody was kind of thinking about it, and you're not exactly sure which way different things influence people's kind of thoughts about it. Like, seems like you said, I'm Pam's friend. We're the ones that are staying here for longer.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff like that. So what do you think, like, in terms of just, like, what we decided to do? So we decided to call Mike, who's the owner of the vehicle that was having trouble. What do you think about that decision?
Part of me thinks that we should have just called a taxi driver, because I hate to, like, I know he's working, and I know if I were in his shoes, I don't know how he's feeling, but if I were in his shoes, it would be frustrating for me to get a phone call from someone. It's like, your car's not working, we did the airport. Like, I hate to put that stress on him.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Not that he can't handle it, but I wish, in retrospect,
mm-hmm.
maybe we should have just called a taxi driver right away.
Mm-hmm.
And then just dealt with it later.
Mm-hmm.
Although I suppose, like, you never know. Well, it's just a quick fix.
Yeah.
I just feel bad because, like, we ordered the got this car from him, and then does all this other stuff for us, and then there's still a problem, and I hate that.
Mm-hmm.
I hate that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And what do you think about him calling Josh? Or
that's fine. I think that's good for him. Like, if Josh isn't working today and he has time to come take a look at it, then I think that's great.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel pretty bad if Josh got started and we couldn't, because I
So you kind of have mixed feelings about calling Mike because you're not exactly sure what might have happened, right? Like other things could have happened. It could have been effective or like more to call Mike. So you're kind of still a bit iffy about that, but it's like anything in life, you don't know what's gonna happen. So sometimes you just gotta trust him.
The other thing is probably too, like we were talking about before, I feel like he's done so much for us already.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't wanna keep adding to that list.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
And then also just the whole relationship we have in general, I don't like to ask for him for help from him.
Yeah, for sure. Okay. So let's talk about more your feelings surrounding that kind of event and situation now, if that's okay with you. So what would you say was your main sort of affect?
So I would say, like, I think part of me gets kind of cold and not necessarily crabby, but, you know, I want things to work. I want people to, that's just hard to say. Let's see here. If everyone was standing around staring in the steering column, I would have been, like, pissed off.
What's the steering column?
The steering column. Like, if everyone was looking at those wires where they attached, that would have been too much, and I would have probably gotten angry.
Right.
And be like, go away, you know,
yeah.
Which is silly.
Yeah, but fair.
That would have been one thing. On the other hand, if everyone had just pissed off, and sorry, if everyone had just left and not even cared, that would have also bothered me a lot. You know, so there's a fine line where you don't want people breathing up your nose, but then on the other hand, if they go too far, you're like, does no one else care about this thing?
Yeah.
Yes, so there's those two things. But I think you guys did the right thing. I mean, the other thing is that, you know, you guys, we don't have, like, we have one phone here.
Yeah.
All our connections are kind of through that phone. You know, so it's hard to, what else are you going to do? You know?
Mm-hmm.
That is my favorite question.
The question was, what was the main sort of affect that you were feeling during the event?
Yeah. I was trying to be stoic, but I think that I was just kind of frustrated.
Yeah.
I hate it when things don't work.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Was there anything else that you were feeling?
I guess, like...
Sorry, I'm supposed to say. Oh. So what are the other things that you were feeling? Sorry.
Other things I was feeling were when June and Helen walked out. Like, I don't understand. They just don't seem very helpful.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if someone is in a sticky situation like we were getting, or not getting ourselves, but we were getting into, like... Did they talk to you guys?
Pam went up and talked to Helen. Pam approached Helen.
Because I didn't hear that part, but like they just don't seem very helpful, which was frustrating. And then what else? Josh was really helpful, like saying, you know what, maybe she's got a cab, and he was in the mix. That was really great. And
mm-hmm.
Michael for even like talking. And that's what we're
okay, so you felt frustrated kind of for a variety of different reasons. Like you're frustrated because you feel like it's your responsibility, and you're frustrated because you feel like people that maybe should help, like the people that we're staying with.
Oh.
The people that we're staying with, they don't, and like in the past too, I'm sure that that's where that's coming from a bit, that they're not super helpful, so that kind of just adds to like the stress level of it all.
Absolutely.
What do you think that Mike was feeling?
It's hard to say, you know. I hate to put words in his mouth.
Mm-hmm.
If I were in his situation, which I'm not, and I'm not who he is,
mm-hmm.
I'd be like, you know, work my tail off. I get this Jeep ready for these girls, and now it's not working.
Mm-hmm.
And part of me, I think another reason why I'm kind of, is like, I don't want it to be something I ended up broken.
Yeah.
Me, myself, and I was like, but it's Joby. Like, I don't want it to. He finds it and he's like, you know what, you blew the starter when you first started driving.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd be like,
mm-hmm.
That's mm-hmm. completely my fault. So I hope it's something that wasn't avoidable, that I could have done differently.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah, for sure.
So I have no idea what he's feeling, which is kind of another reason, you know, that's where I am with him, where I am, because I don't know what goes through his head.
Right.
And I hate to put things there.
Yeah.
Or,
yeah.
Because I don't know.
Yeah. Okay.
I hope it doesn't stress them out.
Right. So overall, it was, you know, you sounded like you're feeling frustrated. But you still seem like, you still seem like.
Do I seem like angry?
No, you don't seem like you're super angry. I still think that you know, like, I think that you know that you did what you could do, and it all worked out. Pam got in the taxi, mm-hmm. and it was all good for that reason. And yeah, you're perceptive about other people and like, just yeah, how things kind of panning out, right? Like with us as the hosts, then two guests, one guest that needs to get to the airport. You commented on each of the people and how you kind of felt, and also Mike and Josh and how you kind of felt. They were, you know, how the situation was for them. So yeah, I think that's all.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.